Alright, welcome to Fix My Doc. And I ordered a water bottle or canteen, whatever you want to call it, holder for my Appalachian Trail hike. This is what I got, was the One Tigress Outdoor Products water bottle carrier. It's as minimalist as I could possibly get that would use the Molly attachment system. And with the backpack that I'm taking, it has the Molly webbing strap attachment system for the waist belt. And this arrived in the mail today, so let's open it up. I purchased this with myself, with my own money. It was not sponsored or anything like that. And I can't remember the exact cost. When Addie walks by, I'll ask her if she remembers how much it cost. So basically, this is what it looks like. Right there, and I got a couple of different bottles here I want to try it with. I'm really hoping that it works well with this style bottle, because this is the type of bottle I want to use on the trail. It claims that it will work perfectly, and it's designed for a standard 1 liter Nalgene bottle, and it claims that it will handle bottles like this. So if it does, then it should work perfect with this. If it doesn't work with this, then I'll just go with this bottle on the trail. So we're going to see right here, right now. So here's the Molly strap to weave it into my waist belt. And then it's got a whole bunch of the loops right here. So those of you that know how to use Molly straps understand what these loops here are for. Basically, you get these loops on your pack, and you get these loops on here, and then you weave this strap here between the loops on your pack and these loops, weave in and out, and then it gives you a good, strong, secure fit so it doesn't fly off or get yanked off or anything. It makes it one with each other. Let's see here. From what I understand, I can adjust it by moving this Velcro here, and then it will slide back and forth like that. To probably want to leave a little bit on there to make it as big as I think is possible. So that's as big as possible right there. So we'll start with that. And then you have this bungee tab here, which you can stretch and pull over the top of the bottle. Let's look at this tag here real quick. Tigress into the wild. And does it open or anything? No, it doesn't open. I was hoping it'd open up and give us some information, but it doesn't. Okay. So let's start with the Powerade bottle, which is basically the same as a Gatorade bottle. The Powerade bottle is basically the same. And it does seem to fit. I can even tighten that up some. Awesome. That's going to be perfect. Let's see here. Let's tighten it up a little bit. I don't want it too tight because I want to be able to pull it in and out, but at the same time I want it tight enough so it doesn't fall in and out on its own. And then I take this. That's going to be absolutely perfect. Yes. That's exactly what I was hoping for and wanting. We're carrying on my back, on this, my backpack waist belt. Now my backpack does have side pockets, but to reach around behind your back to get to the water bottles in your side pockets and pull them out is one thing, but to actually reach around and put the bottles back in is kind of difficult. And so I like having a water bottle right here on my hip belt, where I could just pull it out. And let's see, I should probably loosen this up just a little bit. Yeah. Make it a little bit looser. See if that slips in and out better. Okay, let's try it again. Little example here. Got it there. Imagining it being on my waist belt. Voila. It's apparently the bottom of this Powerade bottle is bigger than the top. So let's loosen it up a little bit more. It's like an hourglass figure shape. Maybe I'll go with the Gatorade bottle instead. There we go. That's better. And it'll be much easier to pull in and out when it's actually physically attached to my waist belt. But I think that's a good size right there. There we go. So, there you have it. Now this is adjusted nice and neat and perfect for the Powerade bottle. Let's undo it all and try it out with the other bottles. Let's go with this one. It's about the same. So it holds on to there. It's kind of a dusty bottle because it's been sitting on my shelf for a long time. There you go. Fits that bottle just fine. And of course, I would adjust it for the size and width and everything of this bottle, but I don't really want to undo the adjustment that I made for the Powerade bottle because that's the bottle I want to take. So. And then the bigger bottle. Fits on that. About the same as my Powerade bottle. There you go. I have it. Fits the full size Nalgene as well. So, pretty nice. Liking it a lot. The Powerade back in. Sets right back in. And perfect. Absolutely perfect. So, there you have it. That is how I carry my water bottle for backpacking. And the water bottle that I carry in here will be the water bottle that I use for mixing my juice, my tea, juice, Powerade mixes, whatever, that I'll be carrying. The longer you hike, the more electrolytes, sugars, and nutrients you burn and use up. So in the morning, you would want to start your hike with, you know, regular water. Just plain water is perfect for in the morning when you start. And then in the afternoon, you want to start moving towards a 50-50 mix of something like Gatorade and water or Powerade and water. Or something that adds whatever you want to mix to your water 50-50 that will add the electrolytes that you are losing. And then in the evening, when you're still continuing to hike, the last third of the day, then you want to do a straight up Powerade or Gatorade type drink. So in the morning, the first third of the day is straight up water. The last third of the day is straight up sports drink. And the middle third of the day, it's a 50-50 mix. So that's why I want to have a water bottle on my hip where it's really quick and easy to access, and I can just mix my drinks up into it with no trouble. And I want to use this type of bottle because when it gets manky and nasty, I can just throw it away and then buy a new one to replace it. And if I take one of these bottles here, I don't want to just throw away one of these bottles, and I don't want to have to worry about trying to find a brush or take a cleaning kit or something to get down inside there, because it's not that easy to clean the insides of Nalgene's. So, especially when you're backpacking on the trail. When you're at home, it's pretty easy, but when you're on the trail backpacking for months on end, it's not that easy. So, if I took one of these, it'd be hard to clean. It'd serve the same purpose, but then I would have to get rid of it or find a way to clean it at some point. This purpose here, I just toss it when I'm done with it and get a new one. So, and when I mean by throw it away, I mean you could toss it. These are all recyclable, so I can find a, see it says recycle, so I can recycle them all into recycle bins, which are all over the country, so that's good. All right, and that would be this company, One Tigress Outdoor Gear. And you can go to www.onetigress.com, find this product. And it was under $12 is what I remember. I don't remember the exact price, but it was right around $12. So if you like it, go check it out. It's the most slimmest, most ultralight version of a water bottle holder that I could find, short of going with this type here. You see the rubber piece that the D-ring is attached to. Short of going with something like that and having it dangling around, when you have something dangling around, you lose a whole lot of energy that way. This will hold it, something like this will actually hold it nice and firm and keep it from wobbling around and shaking all over the place. It'll keep it nice and firmly attached to your pack. And that's what I was looking for. So if you want something firm and attached to your pack, this was the lightest I could find. All right, thanks for watching Fix Badock, and have a great day.